Hi everyone, and welcome back to Feature Friday. This is Sandy Adams Photography, and I am Sandy Adams. If you're joining me today, I'm streaming live into Facebook and also into LinkedIn. If you're watching this live, thank you so much. You're welcome to ask me questions during this broadcast. And if you're watching it on the recorded version, just pop it into the comments section and I will answer it afterwards. So as again, thank you so much. I'm hoping to end this Friday afternoon with a little bit of sunshine in the photo shoot that we're going to talk about today. So what is Feature Friday? It's where I go back into my archives and I bring out a photo shoot and an iconic portrait that I shot from that photo shoot. Today's photo shoot will be a high school senior girl. This was done back in 2014 and she simply had one request. She said, Sandy, I just want to have pretty pictures. And her name is Alexis, and I was happy to oblige with that. And it wasn't actually very hard at all to give her some pretty pictures. So before we get started, just a little bit, if you follow me on Facebook, you can find me at Sandy Adams Photography. If you are Instagram, you can find me at SAP underscore portraits. And for all my behind the scenes videos and a lot of other instructional information, you can find me on my YouTube channel at Sandy Adams Company. Now, if you want to find all about my portrait business, you can find me at sandyadamsphotography.com. Okay, guys, as I said, let's get started with today's photo shoot. So as I said, today we're going to talk about Alexis. And Alexis was a 2014 senior from Dobie High School here in the Houston, Texas area. And this is one of my favorite pictures right here. I typically use this for a lot of my marketing. This really, again, showcases my style, how I like to shoot. And it actually, I use this quite a bit. I have this blown up into about a 22 by 24 image, and it is framed in a white frame. And I routinely use this if I have any type of display somewhere. If I donate auction items quite a lot, portrait shoots, and so I will use this image as a basis behind the auction item to showcase my photography. And this to me is just really epitomizes my style of photography. Okay, so now let's go to this one. Now, this is probably one of my absolute favorites. It is a close-up version of her. It is straight on. She's not smiling. That is typical in a lot of my portraits. But as you will see as we go through today's presentation, that she has a beautiful smile, and I did showcase that quite a bit today. But this is one of my iconic portraits. I really like this. The struggles that I had on the day of the shoot was that there was no sun. There was no green grass. There was very little leaves on the trees. And it was just kind of an ugly overcast day. And the ground, this was actually in early March of 2014. The ground still had not grown a lot of grass. Everything was kind of brown and ugly. And so I really had to do use some different colorings in post-production to kind of bring her portraits to life. Now, the most editing I did on these images was the coloring, and that really just made her images pop. It was kind of different from how I normally shot, but for her and her shoot, everything about it just kind of screamed that that's the kind of coloring technique that I used. I did do a few in black and white, but typically it had this bright yellow cast, this bright yellow coloring to it that really just showcased her smile and just made everything seem really sunny. Okay, so the next one is this one. Now this one is straight on. It's similar to this one, except I do have the tree trunk in the foreground and also the limbs. I'm again shooting through them. The thing for a lot of people is that if you're going to put stuff in the foreground and put the client farther back, then you really need to make sure that you're not shooting to a point where everything is really, really blurred. I do shoot normally with a lot of prime lenses, typically a 35 millimeter with my second favorite lens would be a 50 millimeter. Yes, they're all prime lenses. Occasionally I'll bring out my 85, but that's usually for headshots. Typically though, I shoot with a 35 millimeter prime lens and a 50 millimeter prime lens. I do pretty much the opposite of what everybody else does, and that's okay. That's my style. That's how I shoot. That's what I love to do. It does require that I move around a lot more because I'm not using a zoom lens. But what I really, and I really like shooting wide open, which means that a lot of this, the images that, a lot of the items that are not on the same focal level as she is would be really blurred. And so I had to make sure that I adjusted that and not shoot as wide open so that it wasn't as blurred and it wouldn't be too distracting. Because I still wanted some, I wanted to get some idea of what it was and not blur it too much, because I thought that would really take away from the image itself. So here is the same image, but I gave it more of, it wasn't a black and white, it was kind of a different one. And I thought that this kind of was a good balance between the overuse of yellow in her portraits. And I thought that this type of blackish white image would be more compatible with the yellowing of her regular images. And I really like this. This is probably, these two images are probably my second favorite of all of her images. This is probably one of my top. So this one and this one are going to be my two favorite images out of this shoot. Again, to me, this really epitomizes my style of photography. It really showcased just her hair. Her eyes were very expressive, her just everything. And yes, she asked for pretty pictures. Pretty doesn't always have to be smiling. Pretty can just be a very expressive face, and that's what I felt she had. And she was just, she just nailed it. None of my clients have previous modeling experience. Some of them, I do use a couple of friends of mine who actually started out as clients. And they're, if I want to go and do like a styled shoot of some kind, because I really have to, in order to get people to hire you for certain things, you have to show them what you're capable of shooting. You have to give them ideas of what they may want to have, what's possible. You have to show them what's possible. And so a lot of times I'll have to go out and create those portraits so that I can show my clients what is possible. So I do have a few people that I use for those type of portraits. And I have a very exciting shoot coming up in the next couple of weeks, and I can't wait to show you guys about it. So here's another one where she is smiling. We found some flowers, or she had actually picked the flower, and I put it into her hair. I thought that really softened it up. The day was really windy. I know it doesn't appear so here, but it actually was very windy that day. And with her hair, it's really thick, naturally curly, and so it worked really well with the high wind. But this one, it just kind of added just a little bit of touch to it, and she just really, as you can see, her smile just kind of brightens up her face. Here is probably my second level favorite pictures. Her smile, her expression, just it just really showcases how excited she was about this shoot. Now, here are two, I like to show you vertical versus horizontal shots. Obviously, the left side is the vertical shot and the right is the horizontal. The right one, I told her not to smile. The wind was coming from the side and I really liked how it was pushing her hair outward. And again, she had the little flower. I posed her arms. And for this, she was bent over. And when you bend over, you need to bring your chin out more because if you bend over, people tend to do this. And you really have to lift your chin up so that it, modeling is not easy. You have to put your body in a lot of weird, interesting ways in order to make it look normal on the photograph. Here, so the image on the left, Alexis liked to draw. She also liked photography. And I actually took out, I actually have an old Hasselblad camera, film camera from the 1950s. And I took it out there to use it as a prop, and she'd never seen one. We opened it up, and what you, if you don't know, when you look through the viewfinder, which is straight down, what you see is the opposite of reality. So if you want to move your camera to the right, it's backwards. So it gets a little bit, having to get used to that. And when she looked down, she didn't know I was going to shoot this. She looked down and she saw that it was reversed, and she started laughing, and I just grabbed that shot. And that's one of the things that you really have to really be watching the whole time, even when you're talking to the client, even when you're moving them around. You really have to watch for their reactions and be ready to grab those shots if you see something that is just natural and just kind of stunning. The one on the right, it's a more serious. She had changed her outfit, obviously, for these pictures. It was a little bit more serious and still a favorite of mine as well. Here are an example of the same image with two different color treatments. The one on the left, I toned down the yellows just a little bit and added a frame around it to make it look really kind of old-like photograph. The one on the right, I changed that into black and white. And you can see how both of them to me are stunning. And it just kind of goes to your personal preference. The thing is with black and white is, clients don't tend to think of black and white. They don't tend to want to ask for that. It's my job to show them things that I think would be great for each image. Not every image that I shoot is meant to be black and white or looks good in black and white. But a lot of times I think black and white images show the person or show the scene much more than it would be in color. Because to me, sometimes color can be distracting, especially if you have bright colors. But in this case, either one of these is stunning in my opinion. Here is she is with her Letterman jacket. As you can see, she was having a grand time. This was towards the end of the shoot. She was so used to my commands then and how to turn and how to move. And she was so excited and just showcasing all of her accomplishments that she had done through college. And she had won several awards and just a really great girl, just super. This is probably one of my favorite shoots, and just the atmosphere about it, just the ambiance about it, and just the spirit that she had in the shoot itself. And again, the wind worked really well with her hair. And I actually love wind. It doesn't typically work though if somebody has thin, fine hair. That doesn't work as well. But if you've got thick hair of any kind and you don't necessarily want it to be still, the wind acts as a great prop too, because it gives more movement to the images. Okay, guys, if you want to learn more about my photography, you can find me at sandyadamsphotography.com as well. So now, for those, if you have any questions, I'd be happy to take those right now. We have one question. How long did it take you, or how do you decide on what clothes the client is going to wear, or do you beforehand? Okay, Marie, thank you for that question. A lot of times I always ask for the clients to book me at least 2 to 3 weeks ahead of when they want to have their shoot. Some of that is just scheduling. Some of that is I want to have at least a week so that I can go over with them what outfits they're going to wear. Typically, I have them take pictures of them and their outfits that they want to use and then send those to me because I want to see how the outfits fit on them. If they just send me a picture of the clothes, it doesn't really do me any good. I don't know how the clothes lay, or I don't see how it looks on them. Now I have told clients that they'll give me choices. I'd rather them take too many to the shoot than too few clothes. And a lot of times we'll get out there and something may not work, and I want to have other options. The other thing is I want to see what they're going to want to wear. If there are a lot of prints, then I want to make sure that the background of wherever I'm photographing them is not busy as well, because you don't want clothes that are really busy to be against a busy background, and because then that's just very very cluttered, and it's hard for your eye to go to what you want it to go to in the image. So thank you very much for that Marie. So I do a little bit of both, but yes, I do work with them. I do typically let them pick out what they're comfortable in. For some of my dream shoots, some of my really elaborate glamour shoots, I do have several outfits and material here in the studio. I do have some material that I can wrap them in. One of the very first Feature Fridays I did was with the girl in the black dress during a storm coming up, and that was actually three pieces of material pinned together and tied together. So it doesn't necessarily have to be, especially for the girls, it doesn't have to be this elaborate dress. I have material that I can wrap them, and it looks like a gorgeous gown. And the whole thing is, I want it to move with the wind. So sometimes an actual dress just doesn't do that. So thank you very much for that, Marie. Okay, guys, that's it for today. I'll be back next Friday for another edition of Feature Friday. And I'll put, so this shoot did have a behind the scenes video, and so I will put it into the post once of this recording is over. If you're watching me live, thank you very much. If you're watching the recorded version, thank you so much for stopping by. Have a great weekend. Stay safe. Bye, guys.